Hi designers, this video we want to focus on the rendering workspace and our overall presentation of the prime time task. So please go through and open this template. It should be on the YouTube video description along with on the assignments or in your OneNote. In here, we want to go through and be including the clock name. So come up with a nice creative name, leave clock design, place in your name down under designer. Think about what font you're going to be using. So look at the font and also think about the colors that you can go through and change here. But probably do that once you bring the image into it, because then you can be pulling out colors within that design and really be sort of highlighting the overall design for best promotion of it. Jumping back to Fusion, we're looking at moving into the rendering workspace. So you're going to have your design. Now, what we want to be going through and doing is be applying appearances at this stage or early in that rendering stage. So you can be going to modify then appearance and then be applying colors here, or we go through and complete it at the rendering stage. The other thing you might have noticed I've gone through and completed is two just little bodies that positioned underneath it just to provide some context to the clock design. So making it look as best as it can go through and appear. So if it was a clock design, you're not going to necessarily be, you know, creating a wall and positioning things around it or putting a window beside it, because we really want to highlight the clock design. But if it was something that would be positioned on a table, so if it's some sort of electronic, you would be, you know, placing or designing the table or trying to put it within its context. So then provide a sense of context and a sense of scale of how big this thing is. So be, yeah, creating maybe something of interest that's surrounding the clock design just to highlight its, you know, its features and just provide a sort of a creative surround for it. These could be just different shapes like I've applied here. So now we want to move from the design workspace into the rendering workspace. At this stage, your design will come across. It will generally look just in terms of the overall textures will be a gray. It won't be appearing like mine with color as yet. And so if you haven't done that as yet, you can go through and be applying, changing the color of everything you've already modeled. Okay, that's using this appearance tab, which should be producing the appearance option over here. Now you can be changing and applying textures to the bodies and the components or individual faces. So if you want the top face to be one color and then the sides to be another, that's where you'll be going through and changing as faces. And you can be changing this sort of throughout as you design. In the design, you'll have no textures, or you'll have one. I think it's generally a metal, might be steel. And so therefore, you want to go through and be starting to develop and include these different textures within your design. If we scroll down and notice that there's sort of two scroll areas here, which might be a little bit confusing, but you will get used to it. And I'll just minimize these. Within the texture library, so this is the appearances of each face. It's not their actual physical attributes. You can go through and change that in another workspace, but we're just looking at applying colors and textures to individual faces. So they can be fabric, glass, leather, liquid, metal, and then metal, you'll have a whole list of them there. Mirror, miscellaneous. So that this underlying shape might have been interesting to do as a mirror. Miscellaneous just has air. Other has things like emissive, so making things lighting, but you can be applying lighting to other textures as well, which I'll go over briefly. Other different environments, so on and so forth. Paint's a really good option as well, whereas you've got different colors, and that's what I've been applying up here. Then within any of these, sometimes you'll have to go through and download them, so it might be a little download symbol that you're doing. And then, because mine's currently rendering and processing at the moment, I won't go through and be applying it, but essentially you're just clicking and dragging and dropping it onto the area that it's currently highlighting. If you do want to go through and change these, so maybe the color's not quite right because these are just a library, you can be going through and changing them. So you can right click and you can edit these, and therefore I can change that color of yellow. I can change the roughness of the texture, so how textured it is or how smooth it is, how reflective it is. If you go into advanced, the other cool option is things like translucency and emissive. So emissive is, this was, you know, remembering this is just a yellow glossy paint, but we can change it so now it's emissive and it's actually emitting light, so it looks more like a well, in this case, like an LED disc. And you can change how emissive that overall design is. So I'll close that for now because I don't need to do that. Then so this one's just dealing with what we've currently modeled. The next setting is a scene setting. And so once again, that will appear from the left-hand side here. And you've got the scene setting and you've got the environment library. So under the environment library, I think it's best to look at this area first. Yours will probably appear like this. And so we can see our model sort of just hovers in space. And if I zoom around, we can see where the light source is there. And this is the room it's taken in. And to here, hopefully I can zoom out a little bit. Whoops. I think it's actually zoomed in. Sorry. This is sort of the drop sheet that it's currently sitting upon. So if it was a product design, which it is, and was getting photographed, they'd have like a white drop sheet behind it from the ground that runs up the wall, and then they'd have lights positioned around it. And so that's what the scene setting is. So any of these with, it's really just changing the lighting positioning, and if it's cool lighting or if it's more photo booth or it's more highlighted, that's what the qualities are changing there. So I can change that to grid lighting and the light quality will change a little bit. Still trying to process it. Yeah, it looks like it might have frozen on me. There we go. Now, you can also be including different fields and plazas. These aren't very helpful in most cases. You can also download custom environments. So these are 360-degree photographs that you can go through and include, and then it will just wrap it around the image. Now, if we were happy with our overall environment, you can change the brightness. So that's how bright the lights are that have been used. You can change the position. This is the position of where the lights are, not the position of the product. So that's where, if it's behind us or if it's in front of us, to the left-hand side, the right-hand side. The position, this will position where the ground plane is. So if it's, you know, 300 mil below, or if it's right underneath. Background environment, so you either change into environment or a solid color. So we can have it as a solid color of yellow, or the environment will generally be that sort of grayer color. Brighten that up a little bit, which I can make it a little bit better. And solid color will generally go that, will generally be a gray. Like that, that looks a bit better. However, I do like it in its environment. The ground plane is turning that on and off, positioning or flattening the ground, having reflections turned on or off, and then how roughened those reflections are. The camera position, so generally perspective is going to be good. And generally the pre-fill, if you've completed photography maybe last semester, you will know. So what our eyes see tend to be 50 mil. So if we change it to 50 mil in length for that focal length, that's going to look like that. If we're doing something a little bit more interesting, so 35 mil is pretty common as well. I'm not too sure if these are updating. It doesn't look like it is. And then another good default is 90 mil. You can then zoom down and change the exposure. So how much light is getting captured in terms of within the camera, not within the actual setting. The depth of field, so what is in focus, you can play around with that. But in this case, I'm going to turn that off. And as I said, we've looked at the overall environment, so I'll close that. The next one is the decal. So if you want to include, hopefully I can just give a little image here because we're not necessarily wanting to do it within ours. But if you want to include a logo on it, that's where you can go through and do that. Best thing to do is PNGs and have a translucent background, so then you don't have like a white sort of surrounding box that's really identifiable. The next one is the texture mapping. Not that we're going to worry about it within this, but if you've used wood grain, texture controls is you can select the texture that you want to go through and do, and then you can check effectively change its positioning. So if it's wood grain and the wood grain's running the wrong way, you're going to be able to go through and rotate it or just position it, scale it, those sort of things. That's what that is. Then we have the in-canvas render, which will just do a better quality rendering of this. As we can see, it's starting to process. However, this works using your graphics card and obviously your computer, so it's going to chew through the battery a little bit quicker. And so you just get it to around about that excellent sort of standard. Then you can go through and save that. The other option is, which I go through and use, is the online rendering. And so that's where you're selecting the little teapot. It will take a little bit more time to go through and process. It'll probably take about 10 or 15 minutes per image. Just use a custom preset, but you can be going through and changing these for other assignments. And notice that it always needs one cloud credit. However, with the education license, you always have one cloud credit. So you can just click render and then it will start processing a rendering down here, which I've gone through and done previously. So some of them are more of an animation based one where the image actually rotates. This one is what not to do. So obviously we don't want to clock on a 18th century Victorian cobblestone setting. It doesn't make any sense. It detracts from your design. Whereas we want something more like these where it's sort of focusing on our design. One that has the whole design and one that maybe focuses more so on certain features of it. And so if we just open this, we'll then be able to go through and save it to our computer and then drag and drop it into that Illustrator template to make it a bit more presentable. It might take a little bit of time just because it's trying to render here as well. We can see it's trying to process. Once that's processed, we can go through and just download that. And so download as a JPEG or PNG. See this image, I've got the blur on, so I don't necessarily like that. It's blurring too much, so I'm losing that detail. So I would want to take that depth of field off. And then I'm going to go back into here. I think I've already saved this image. I'm going to go to file, then place, or you can drag and drop these in. Then find the image. There's one. Place that, and I can just click and drag that over there for now. So it will include a hell of a lot of the surround, especially with most of ours being the length and the height being pretty similar or being identical. So now what we can go through and do is, let's just see, drag this into here, and then I can just send that to back. So arrange, send backwards, and notice that the shortcut is control bracket near P. So I can just do that. Control P is print. I don't want to print it as yet. Control bracket next to P. There we go. And then I might position that somewhere there. And then I'm going to select the box and the image, right click, make clipping mask. That's cropped it down. See, I've cropped a little bit out. So you probably could crop some out. This one, try and have it displaying the whole clock design. This one, you can crop it out. So it's just really highlighting an interesting feature and probably have them from the same angle. If they're really different angles, it's not going to look very cohesive. And the other thing, probably have it on a bit more of an isometric angle where we can actually see the depth of the objects, knowing that they aren't very thick, we sort of want to go through and highlight that. So we're really promoting what the key characteristics of the design are. As I said, I'd go through and change this color and also the type color, just to drag it in line with more of this yellowy color that's included here, or a contrasting color to that. So something like a blue or a purple or a green, red might look really strong with that as well, just to best show off our design. Thanks very much.